Behind me is one of the busiest blocks on the University of Ghana campus, the NNB. Several lectures go on right here on a daily basis. But with the UTAG strike just starting, this block might be empty for the next few weeks, months, or even more. But for students, this is not good news at all.
It's going to be a very hectic semester, looking at how this is going to affect us. I mean, last semester, a similar thing happened. We're not able to come to school on time and really affected our work. Most of us have long essays to write, which is going to really affect us because we won't get supervision, you know, you have to get lecturers supervising you.
We met two Malians who are just enrolled in the university for a master's program.
I'm really scared because I'm a foreigner. I come from another country, so I was expecting here to everything to be as I was expecting, good and no strike, because this governmental school, they said, is better than private schools and everything. So I was not expecting this kind of things to happen.
I was feeling somehow, because I was wondering how a Ghana here can have this kind of strike. Because I was even saying that it's almost the same as in our country, because over there too you are having strike. And
well, the University Teachers Association insists it will not back down on its strike until government does something about the 2013 agreed basic salaries. But what is the implication on the ordinary parent who probably struggle to pay fees for their wards? Will they be getting value for their money?
It will not help me as an individual, and it will not help the country, the population as a whole. Because we are planning. So if I've organized her to be in school, I don't expect that she'll be idling around. And it's time. Time waits for no man. So we should, maximize the negotiations and see what to do.
Here at the University of Professional Studies, academic work is at its tail end. Although freshers are now coming to campus, continuing students are in their revision week, meaning they're unsure about what examinations will be like without lecturers.
Lecturers are going to give us our exam papers, invigilate and the rest. So if they are on strike, I don't think it will be easy for us here. We're not going to have our exam, maybe at all.
Until government addresses the concerns of UTAG, students in the public universities remain the most affected. Judith Awotritando, TV3 News, Accra.